This is what it all started with. A good tripod is still a standard in movie industry, and today I'm gonna share with you some tips on how to choose a good tripod, how to use it, some life hacks, and so on. Let's go! What's good, guys? My name is Oleg Nikitin, and you're watching No Limits On channel. And today I'm outside, it's plus 35 degrees Celsius, but in the shade it's pretty okay. We'll start off with choosing a good tripod, guys. So, first of all, you should look at its weight and size, of course, and the weight capacity. What cameras are okay and will be working perfectly with this tripod and tripod head. Also, you need to look at the minimal distance of work with this tripod or which one you're choosing, and the maximum height of it. This tripod is showing great results in the minimum and the maximum height. Also, it's important to mention that if the tripod head has a fluid head and has some amount of resistance or drag, as they call it, it's a great feature. This E-Image GH06 fluid head has three amounts of resistance in terms of pan and in terms of tilt, and also it has the counterbalance with up to 5 kilograms, so 5 different steps of counterbalance, and we can balance the cameras up to 5 kilograms on this tripod head. And one more great thing is the ball head. So I can basically put it in any direction and have the horizon leveled with this ball head. As you can see, it's not a very stable and even surface, so I have an option to level it up even if I put it like so. Then, guys, we're going to talk about how to balance a camera on your tripod. Yeah, you have to balance your camera not only on the gimbal, but also on the tripod. I'm sorry for my noisy neighbors, but, you know, it's a big house right here. We put to zero all the drag and the counterbalance. So it's on zero right now. As you can see, the camera is moving from one side to another with ease. And then we have to slide the plate with the camera to find the balance when the camera is looking straight. I can turn on the camera and see my electronic horizon level, and now I can see that it's pretty much balanced. If it was like so, it would fall like so, but if I do it like this and it doesn't fall, yeah, it stays like this. I simply lock it into place and then I apply a little bit of counterbalance. So the lowest I can apply is 1 on this tripod head, and the maximum is 5, 1-step increments. And basically, as you can see, I tilted the camera and it goes back. Tilted the camera and it goes back. The thing is that the Sony a6300 and the cage and the lens 24-70 Sony f4 with the IS, it's not that heavy. It's less than 1 kilogram, and that is why the counterbalance is not working properly. So what do we have to do? Either we have to apply some more weight, something like put a monitor on top, or use a heavier camera, or just leave it as it is and use it like so. But basically, if you're balanced correctly, 100%, when you do like so, the camera should stay in this position. And when you release it, it should stay. So right now, it's not the best choice. I had the Sony FS7, much beefier and bigger camera, let me show you, with a gimbal, by the way, in this backyard. And basically, I could balance this camera with the counterbalance at the number 3, like 3 kilograms of counterweight, or at number 4, 4 kilograms of counterweight, depending on the lens and the whole setup. So this is how you balance your camera, and with this, the laws of physics and your movements and the work of tripod will be helping you, not resisting. And also, you can add an amount of resistance, like number 1 is okay for me, for a lot of smooth and nice motion. So guys, now let's talk about the basic tripod movements, and also let's see the different amounts of resistance. So then now the resistance is at 0, and as you can see, I can pan and tilt with very fast motion, and hello to roll and shutter effect of the Sony a6300. Then let's apply the first amount, the first stage of resistance, the first whatever. And as you can see, it's now much, much smoother. Be careful with panning and tilting. Yeah, the pan is the first movement and the tilt is the second, and pan plus tilt is the third. Be very gentle and careful with panning and tilting. Let's switch to the third amount of resistance. And now it's getting even smoother. Be careful with the speed of your panning and tilting, because you can introduce some strobe depending on the focal length it should be even slower. So at 70 millimeter on a crop camera, I should pan really, really slowly, not to introduce a lot of strobe. And also it depends on your shutter speed. The shorter the shutter speed, the more visible the strobe is. And there is one more life hack, but I have forgotten the rubber bands for your hair or for your girlfriend's hair or your daughter's hair at home. Basically what you do is you put your rubber strap right here, rubber band, and because it stretches a little bit, your motion would be even better and smoother. You start it very slowly, it stretches of course, and basically you get even smoother shots with a good beginning and nice end, very smooth one. And one more life hack is that you can lift your tripod. It's a pretty heavy tripod, around 5 kilograms right now in my hands, and you'll get good amount of stableness in your footage. As you can see, it's pretty stable. Yes, the lens does have the built-in IS, but still the Sony a6300 is very shaky, especially on the crop sensor body, kind of 35 equivalent of focal length. So this is also a nice life hack, and I used it a lot when I was shooting with a monopod or with a tripod. When you extend your two front legs at the middle range and the back leg to the maximum amount, you can use it as a top-down camera. If it was the table right here, it would kind of lean on a table and have a much better shot. Thank you for going away, you little tractor. distractor. Such a humor from a Russian true humor, guys. And as you can see, we have a... It's again working. As you can see, guys, right here we have a pretty nice top-down shot, and I've been using it, this technique a lot in my top-down shots when I didn't use the, you know, the crane or the stand with the ability to put it like a crane. So, a good thing to know. Also, guys, you can use your tripod as a monopod. Extend one leg and you can basically tilt your camera a little bit to the side, or kind of roll effect, and you can lift it up, go to another location fast, put it like so, take a couple of shots, lift it up, and so on. And one more piece of advice is to buy a good set of sticks and a good ball head or a tripod head, and to use it for decades. Instead of buying for 1 or 2 or 3 years the cheap tripod and be angry at it because it's not fluid enough, not that stable, and overall cheaper and worse product. And of course, I use this tripod a lot in my studio, my YouTube space, and I use it for like 95% of the shots for my A-roll, for my talking head, and of course for my B-roll shots. Fluid movement, even with the macro lens like 105 mm, very, very gentle shots, and I use this a lot and really satisfied with it. So let's talk about this tripod in particular. So the sticks, they're called E-Image 761AT, and they weigh 2 kilograms, and the ball head, 75 millimeter ball head, is E-Image GH06, and it weighs 2.9 kilograms. So the overall tripod weighs around 5 kilograms, which is not really lightweight. Its minimum height is only 13 centimeters, guys. Look at how low it is. And the maximum height is 170 centimeters. I'm 183 centimeters. Height, and this is 170 plus the head around 15 centimeters, and we get around 180-185 centimeters of working height, which is great. Maximum payload is 20 kilograms for the sticks and 6 kilograms for the fluid head. Of course, since it's a ball head, it has a bubble level right here, and you're able to level your shots without looking at the camera's leveling electronic. Just simply looking at the bubble level, you'll get pretty leveled and even shots. As I've mentioned before, 3 steps of drag for tilt, for your pan also 3 steps, and 5 steps of counterbalance, which allows you to get the best performance out of your tripod for different scenarios. Also, this head contains 2 threads for mounting your accessories, the smaller one, 1/4 inch, and 3/4 inch, if I'm not mistaken, the bigger one, for mounting your monitors, sound devices, and all that stuff, so it's a pretty convenient thing to have. The tripod head features Manfrotto plate, which is Manfrotto 501PL or Manfrotto 577. It's compatible, and you can put your Manfrotto plate in here, but the locking mechanism, which is here, won't be working with it. So I have to push this button to release the camera, and with the Manfrotto thing, it won't be working. And the last thing I'd like to mention about this tripod, and especially the tripod head, the ball head, is that this handle is extendable and it extends like so. And you can use your tripod from very far away. For example, you're sitting somewhere low on the ground, you can adjust it and use it like so, looking at your monitor and not, you know, interrupting the people in the audience if you're shooting a concert or whatever. So it's a great thing to have as well. And one more thing. This tripod is suggested by Gerald Undon, Pro AV TV, and Philip Bloom. If you know those guys, they're pretty respectable. Okay, a lot of people, a lot of filmmakers and YouTubers respect their opinion, and I as well. Respect. So guys, I've been using this tripod for around 5 years and I have no complaints except for the weight of it. 5 kilograms is a little overkill for most of scenarios, but if you have a bigger camera or you need a very sturdy, very fluid tripod, look at this one in particular. So guys, if you enjoyed the content on my channel, please smash the like and subscribe buttons that are standing on that tree right now, and the notifications bell, of course, to be notified when I post my next video. And this was Oleg Nikitin, and by the way, write down in the comment section below which tripod do you use, and maybe send us some links down in the description. Yeah guys, that's been it. My name is Oleg Nikitin, you've been watching No Limits On, and I see you in the next video. Take care guys, bye.